So that in no way takes us to Apostasy, but it is the next film that we're going to be talking about anyway. So in that regard, I suppose it does, but there's no thematic link between this. But Drew, you want to tell us about Apostasy?
Yeah, it's how do you link superhero cartoon sequel to Jehovah's Witnesses, Scott? That's a tricky
one. In many
one.
Ways, in many ways, isn't God the ultimate superhero?
Is it in many ways? Isn't Mr. Incredible Jehovah's Witness? Okay, well, your way makes more sense.
Yahweh makes a lot of sense. That's a different religion, though, I think.
Oh, no, it's the same religion, just a different language. Tetragrammaton and all that.
That's like Equilibrium, though, right, wasn't it?
Alex, Molly Wright, an 18-year-old suffering from Chekhov's blood disorder, lives with her mother, Ivana, Siobhan Finneran, and her older sister, Louisa, Sasha Parkinson, near Manchester. The three are all devout, proselytising members for the local Jehovah's Witness community. Though I believe proselytising is the only acceptable mode for members. A minor sect of Christianity, probably best known to the wider world as being those who, people who turn up on your doorstep trying to give you magazines and who refuse blood transfusions. In hospital, that is. The blood transfusions.
Yeah, not just on the street.
I'm actually pretty okay with them refusing blood transfusions on your doorstep.
Yeah.
You weirdo. Why'd you have all of that blood anyway, and why are you trying to force on other people?
Well, you want to be a good host.
They talk constantly of the new system, which God will enact after the rapture, something, due to its name, which I am unable to think of as anything other than the next version of Windows for Souls, and consider that those not in their church, or in the truth, as they put it, as unsaved, but not unsavable, though they tend not to think too highly of them. However, the harshest judgment seems to come for those within their own community who are deemed to have transgressed. One such is Alex's sister Louisa, who becomes pregnant by an outsider, and to teach her an important lesson of something, is excommunicated and ostracised by her community. The cruelest part of that is that her family are also forbidden from interacting with Louisa, unless strictly necessary, and being pregnant, malnourished and alone apparently isn't sufficient grounds. Lest they be tempted to actually help her, her family also face being punished if they transgress and commit the mortal sin of caring about their relative. This becomes an even harder burden to bear for Ivana after Chekhov's blood disorder goes off at the film's midpoint, and the film's viewpoint switches to her. Ivana must struggle with her faith, the commands of the elders and her instincts as both a mother and a human. Louisa also suffers a great deal, and begins to rebel against the religion which was imposed upon her. Directed and written by Daniel Cocotaggio, himself a former Jehovah's Witness, Apostasy is shot in an almost documentarian style, though the unusual 3:2 aspect ratio isn't used even close to as effectively as First Reform's Academy ratio, which we will come to speak about shortly, though the muted colours and lack of flashiness do reflect the austerity of the religion. And the encounters, conversations and situations have a real ring of truth about them. It would be easy to make the elders, all men, naturally, seem particularly villainous, but thanks to the aforementioned feeling of veracity, Cocotaggio doesn't need to. They, their religion and their utter inflexibility are given enough rope with which to hang themselves without needing to diverge from the mundane. Apostasy is far from perfect. In particular, the use of spoken prayer as a way of voicing the character's thoughts, and at the same time as a narration device, is clumsy, inconsistent, and not particularly effective. But the three main performances, most notably that of Finneran as a devout mother facing a seeming lack of reward for her piousness and faith, are great. And I think by choosing to make this story as a drama, the director brings a humanity to the story that I think a documentary wouldn't necessarily give it, while still managing to make much that is here seem, alas, real. In the end, it's a bleak but interesting insight into a little-known world, delivered with the authority of one who has been there, and is recommended. Will make you furious, though.
Yes, yes. I was very much thinking of the Magdalene Laundries by the end of this. It's a similar sort of blood-boilingly infuriating work. Marriage is a difficult trick of changing your protagonist halfway through, which not a lot of things can do successfully, and I think this works as pretty well because
as well as you could, I think, because it's yeah, that's strange. It changed the viewpoint at the midpoint.
Yeah.
That's a hard one to pull off. I'm not convinced it does it, but I was engaged enough that I kept watching.
I like the idea because it was a character that was almost going towards, not villainy, but, you know, she was clearly not even remotely sympathetic up until that point, and it's trying to make it a bit more sympathetic as the mother goes through the struggles. But yeah, I think I liked it. It's as an atheist, then all this religion's crazy to me. It's just degrees. But this is the craziest one of them. This is one of the crazier ones. Yeah, some really baffling beliefs and strange structures, and I think it's good that it's not wildly sensationalising anything. As you say, it's taken a bit more almost documentarian kind of approach to it, and that really does help the impact of it and show just how weird it is and infuriating some actions are. But at the same time, it's not making them out as pantomime villains. I mean, it's like these people do genuinely believe that this is how is best to save people's souls, and it's hard to be too upset with people for that basis, if you know what I mean. They're not out and out evil or have any kind of lust for power or anything like that, or at least it doesn't seem to be coming across as the way this is shown. It's just that their chosen methods for salvation are really strange.
Yeah, that's absolutely the key. And that's what I said about giving the rope to hang themselves, because these people, they don't feel... It's something along the lines of, like, Hannah Arendt's idea. Obviously, it's not as bad as Nazism or other, but Hannah Arendt's idea of the mundanity of evil. That these people believe that they're helping someone like this, but somehow that detaches them from humanity.
Yeah.
And yeah, cause they're not, it'd be so easy just to make them genuinely evil people. And so many stories about religion have that, whereas, for instance, in the Magdalene Laundries, some of the people there was along the lines of mundanity of evil. Some of them were like Geraldine McCune's character, just straight out evil. This doesn't have that. And it just feels so real. And yeah, they just believe that they're helping. And I've now forgotten the point I wanted to make when I started. So I'll let you continue and maybe it'll come back to me.
I would, but I'm not altogether sure there's much more that I want to say about Apostasy. Yeah, I wouldn't say I was entertained by it. It's not the sort of film that's out.
It's not an entertaining film, but no.
No, but it's and not entertaining or enjoyable, yet still it's worth watching. I was quite affected by it. Certainly, it was an interesting look into this sect, I suppose you'd say, that I didn't really know anything about. Disturbing to see what's actually going on inside it, of course. But nonetheless, it's a film that's well worth tracking down. I would certainly recommend it. It's worth watching.
I mean, films about religion tend to make my blood boil from the beginning, and what I thought was quite notable while I was watching this is that for a lot of it, I didn't feel that. I was more just interested. It really is the approach that Cocotaggio is taking with this, that this feels like this is how these people would operate. I mean, operate sounds like they've got like a really sinister motive, and I think that's not accurate. It's like this is what they believe. And I may think the belief is extremely foolish, misguided, but they believe it, so they think they're doing good. But yes, I say it sort of detaches them from like being kind and caring human when people are suffering because of what they're doing. And so, surprisingly, for a film about religion, for most of it, I was quite calm. And it's actually only towards the end of the film when you see the real consequences of these actions and actually the way the mother was acting.
Yeah.
That my anger began to build. The other thing, though, is that did make me a bit angry, and it's what always bothers me, is just that, do you know what? I mean, I can even understand the idea of not wanting a blood transfusion. As foolish as I find that, because people want to live, right? But if you believe that there's like your, they don't, according to this film anyway, Jehovah's Witnesses don't believe in a soul in the way that other religions might. The actual corporeal body is the thing. This isn't the place or time to get into that. But that if your body is the instrument or the design of God, and that if you're taking a part of somebody else's body, that makes it, I don't know, impure, incomplete or something. I can understand that. That makes sense, that why you would believe that. So therefore you wouldn't want something like a blood transfusion. But at the same point, anything that makes children suffer and potentially leads to the death of children, which is what the beginning of the film's about, that Alex had a blood transfusion and was basically always made to feel unclean or impure as a result of that, despite the fact it saved her life, and otherwise she would have died as a child. And that makes me so angry. That and the company thing. It's like, you know, this is just a general religion thing. And I know we're getting away from the topic of this, so this will be brief, but the idea that I don't think children should be anywhere near religion. If adults believe these things and want to practice religion, that's up to them. But I just don't think any children should be subjected to anything religious, even vaguely, beyond an education that here is what religion is and these people believe these things. Because children don't have the critical faculties for that. But yes, otherwise, I'm going to end up down a massive rabbit hole if I start on this. I'll just say that it approaches it in quite a sensitive and not particularly judgmental way, this film, I think. At least it lets what feels like a real situation tell you all you need to, and then you can make your own judgment rather than the film doing it itself. Does that make sense?
Yeah, yeah.
So it's really interesting from that point of view. And Jehovah's Witnesses, really all I know about or knew about Jehovah's Witnesses before this, I knew they didn't believe in blood transfusions and things. So if they don't believe in blood transfusions, obviously not transplants, etc. But also it's like, you know, Jehovah's Witnesses are largely just the butt of jokes. You know, it's like they're the people that come to the door and want to speak to you, so you hide from them. You hide with Jehovah's Witnesses come to the door because they'll talk to you and you don't want to do that. It's that sort of joke. I think Mormons have sometimes thought of similar, because they do the same sort of door-to-door thing. But beyond that, didn't know much about them. So this is interesting just to learn a bit more about a different thing. And it just interesting, different. I've not seen a film quite like this approaches religion in quite this way, I don't think. Not that I watch a great many of them for reasons that are probably obvious when they ran, I almost went on and sort of did. But it's not entertaining in any way, but it's rewarding. And definitely worth checking out if you can get a hold of it.
Yes, very much.
So, we are, again, unusual for us because we're both largely on the same page with this, but we've got not one but two religious films in our episode today, Scott. So,